I've been getting a lot of headaches lately, and the problem is pretty obvious if you think about it. It's the pesky 5G rays that the government is beaming into my brain. But it's okay, because I have a plan to protect myself from all the electrosmog in my house, using this, and this, and this. No, I'm just kidding you guys. That would look ridiculous. So instead, I've picked up a bottle of Warmore RFIE50, a paint that, when applied correctly, claims to shield you from high and low frequency electromagnetic fields. How, you might ask? Well, not by teasing the folks who believe their Wi-Fi router is causing sleepless nights and cancerous growths. It probably has more to do with the high graphite content of this black base coat. And if this actually works, there are legitimate purposes for a product like this. If blocking unauthorized access to a baby monitor or thwarting keyless car theft could be as simple as a couple coats of paint, they might not only be able to justify the existence of this product, but even its outlandish price. So we decided that, regardless of our own beliefs about the supposed dangers of 5G, we owe it to the tech community and Raymond EMC, whose chamber we haven't really used for anything yet, to find out if this stuff is snake oil or if it actually works. Works like this segue to our sponsor, AMD. The new Radeon RX 7700 XT and 7800 XT are here, with up to 16 gigs of GDDR6 memory and AMD's FSR3 for sharp visuals and high frame rates. These graphics cards dare to ask, what if game but more good? Learn more at the link down below. According to the manufacturer, this stuff can lower RF noise by anywhere from 51 to 78 decibels, depending on the frequency, with just 3 layers of paint. Now, obviously we can't just take their word for it. We're gonna have to try it, which for a normal person would be a relatively easy task. Just turn off your Wi-Fi, use a handy dandy EMF meter like this 48846 from X-Tech to take a reading of the background RF radiation in your space, apply paint all around you, and then measure the difference. For us though, it's not so simple, because this place is quite literally radio frequency hell. We've got multiple high performance wireless access points. We've got our rooftop 60 gigahertz wireless link to the other building, our cell repeater, and our wireless microphones and production gear, not to mention the hundreds of Wi-Fi and Bluetooth enabled devices, all of which are competing for wireless spectrum in this big bouncy concrete box that we call the lab. Allow me to demonstrate. Oh man, Jake. Jeez, you got 10. You've got 10 of them right here. And
how about other phones?
Oh my good, 20. You got a wireless antenna right there. It's gonna sizzle your nipples. Okay. Adam's very busy. We don't want to disrupt him. Oh yeah, these are very, no, no, you're
Can
good.
I
you're
help
good.
You?
Very low RF.
That's great.
Very safe.
Yeah.
Oh no, James has got wireless headphones. Oh, they're wired. That explains why they're basically on par with the background reading then. I see trouble. I can't read it from here.
It's 30, not 40. Wow, actually it does go up when you get closer to the AP.
I mean, that makes sense.
55.
What, 55?
There you go.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Okay, how high can we get it?
80. Whoa. Wow. 85.
Wow, dangerous. What pocket do you keep your phone in?
It's on the desk.
Oh, okay. Well, wow, the readings are really low here.
Nobody texts me anyway.
This is low. Clearly nobody's actually using these servers. Hey, social team, you guys are using the servers, right?
Yeah.
Excuse me, sorry, I just need to, yeah, even farther back.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, all right, thank you. I was thinking, acrylic side panels, beautiful or deadly? Yeah. I think you're gonna be okay.
Okay.
All memeing aside, the inconsistency of our baseline readings is a significant problem if we're trying to figure out if the paint works. Even while I'm standing here, you're watching it fluctuate as much as 3 to 5 volts per meter, and moving just a foot drops it by another 3. Thankfully, we have a solution. Our EMC chamber. In here, we not only have extremely low background noise, this is a very controlled environment. It's 1.5 volts per meter, and that's with the camera right there. It's basically zero without it. But we also have the ability to set up a completely self-contained 5G network, which will allow us to use not Wi-Fi, but harmful 5G to test out a variety of different shielding solutions. Let's start with one of the more obviously predatory ones, like this hat from EMR Shielding Solutions. It's $70 US, and its claim to fame is that, aside from looking absolutely fabulous, it is lined with 10% copper / silver, which, given the difference in cost, I wouldn't mind knowing which one is which, but oh well. For our test, we've got our 5G network enabled, which you can actually see right here. We have a 5G compatible phone, and we have a screen recording running that should allow us to put it under the hat and see if it works. Not gonna lie, I played around with this a little bit before we rolled the camera, and we have a bit of an issue. Every time we've ever done this kind of thing in the past, we've used Wi-Fi, which is a lot easier to block than a cellular signal because of the different bands and the waves. And so this doesn't do anything, but I was actually expecting it to do something. Pinned at 80, is that what you were expecting?
Basically.
Okay, cool. Let's move on then. Next up is this 5G blocking fabric from Atmosure. Do I look swindler enough right now?
Where's the transmitter?
Depending which of the marketing brochures you pick up, these guys oscillate between totally reasonable, with claims like sewing their fabric into your pockets could help block credit card skimming, all the way to move to a smaller town in rural area where 5G rollouts may not happen anytime soon. Let's give it a shot. Now you see 5G. Now you don't. It's like 10 seconds to refresh the reading. 1 second. Boom! Whoa.
Whoa. All right, it works.
Be nice if you could manually refresh it. Like the phone thinks it has 5G already.
Yeah.
It broke it.
I don't know how you do it, Linus. You didn't even drop it.
I did nothing. I break things. It's not my fault, I swear to you. Okay, so I should try this again, because maybe something bad happened. Minus 83 decibels? Now you don't! Oh, what the? Oh, I know what it is. It's capacitive. Dang it. Now for my next trick, we're using a different interface, because it refreshes a little bit faster. But I'm going to make this 5G signal, at minus 84 decibels, disappear! Now you see it? Oh yeah, minus 94. Why didn't I think of this earlier? Just come in here with it. Ugh. I can totally breathe. Minus 99. Dang, this stuff kind of does something. Let's move on to our paint. Let's take a closer look at this boy. Made in Canada. Very nice. Very breathable with low VOC content, which actually does matter when you're applying a paint. They say it contains no toxic solvents, plasticizers, or other toxic ingredients. It's water-based, containing mostly an acrylic binder, water, natural graphite, and carbon black. And while I said a whole bunch of stuff about how non-toxic it is, I would like to point out that none of this is actually unique in the paint industry, and I would strongly suggest that you not consume any of this, however non-toxic it might be. By the way, as we discovered during the creation of our test enclosure, it is even more cloth stainy than thermal paste, so make sure you are super careful when you're using it. Rather than painting a room, we decided to paint a box. With movie magic! Wow, look at that! We painted this whole box with three coats. Cool. Because our box has some small gaps in it, we used foil tape to cover them, and we'll be using the same to seal our phone inside. We just need to devise a test that allows us to actually monitor what the bloody thing is doing. Well, here's one thing. I can put it in and see if that does... Oh, wow. I actually have really high hopes for this. It's not even enclosed. Okay, hold on. 93, which is worse. Oh, minus 105! And it's still got a big gap. Buddy? Minus 102? Oh, they haven't even sealed it in there. 106? Okay, that's not 70 or 80 decibels or whatever, but That's something. It's 25. And that's on a cardboard box. How about a practical demo? What does this mean in real world terms? Or wait, do we have internet? Oh, perfect. Then I'll just go to YouTube. Why does everybody put 5G in their house? This is great. I actually have I have no idea how much that costs.
A little bit more than my phone.
I mean, while we're at it, why doesn't everybody have the new stubby screwdriver from LTTstore.com? I've got an LTT video loaded up here. I'm going to go ahead and change the quality to, I mean, let's go 4K, right? We're at 4K and I've got stats for nerds overlaid. So you can actually see right now our connection rate is about 40 megabit as measured by Stats for Nerds. Now, let's go ahead and drop it into the boom! We are down to 30. I don't know, 33, 34. Still, that's quite a bit lower and it gets better. Let's go ahead and start to close it. We're down to 20, under 20. And 18. 10, 3. It will almost certainly buffer very soon. Oh, it's buffering! It's buffering! It cannot play. I don't even need to seal this. It cannot play the video. Oh, she's going. Okay. Well, we are not going to know for sure exactly when or how it cuts out because I have no way of monitoring the screen inside the box. But we can go ahead and seal it up. Thanks, Colin. All right. I gotta tell you, I wasn't sure exactly what to expect today, but it wasn't for it to be this good. I kind of thought this was going to be more like the hat. Like, oh yeah, 5G blocking paint. If you're trying to block 5G, I mean, to paint a box. I guess. Oh, I'm so glad we have that other box. Can you hand me the control box, which was totally our intention the whole time? Let's pull this out of here. Maybe cardboard blocks 5G. Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
I'm pulling it out and, oh yeah, she's struggling, 2 megabit. And you can actually see that during a lot of this, it's not able to transfer anything. Now that we're back up here, it's playing, we're at 4 megabit and it looks like it's gonna keep climbing because it's actually above the scale. Very cool. Now, something the savvy among you might have realized or thought of at this point is that if this is 5G millimeter wave, just about anything could block it. It's not millimeter wave, but if it were, a piece of paper could block it. So let's go ahead and see, is it just the fact that our network sucks? We're at 47 megabit right now. Let's go ahead and drop it in. Oh boy, we're at 54. this is not 5G enhancing cardboard, I promise you that much. Doesn't seem to be making any difference. It's at 59. Okay, no, really. Don't take away the wrong conclusion here, you guys. But there's one major thing we haven't addressed yet. While EMR Shielding Solutions Inc. does claim protection against high frequency RF, microwave, and low frequency electric fields, they require you to ground it. So they actually sell a kind of foil tape that you can run along the baseboards in the painted area. Then you paint over it with this stuff, which is supposed to act more like a primer or a base coat, and then you apply your regular paint over top of this so that your guests don't need to know that you get your news from InfoWars. Anyway, our box is grounded now. Let's go ahead and try it one more time. I'm not really expecting it to change that much. I suspect this is more about the blockage. Okay, 50 megabit. Yeah, that's not too bad for 4K YouTube. All right. And, there we go. Okay, we're down to 40, 38, 37, 35. She's dropping. Okay. 15. Will it be even more effective? Down to 3 megabit. And she's buffering. It's not the most scientific test either. I'm not necessarily convinced that's making a ton of difference, but sure. If you were going for the most effective covering possible, then you would probably want to ground your paint. But you'd also probably want to remove your doors and your windows. So given that your house, no matter what you do, is going to be less sealed and less grounded than this, so I suspect that if your goal was to completely block any kind of signal in or out, you are going to be sorely disappointed. The good news is that nothing that we've looked at today, including me standing right next to this 5G antenna, is anywhere near Health Canada's guidelines for prolonged exposure to electromagnetic fields. And in fact, according to their guidelines, unless the device is quite literally heating up your skin, there is no scientifically established long-term effect to the frequencies that are emitted by consumer electronics. And there's even more good news. If your goal was not to achieve some kind of health benefit, but simply to attenuate the RF signals from any device inside your box, like a car key in that spoofing example that we gave you guys earlier in the video, then this actually works way better than I expected, and it could absolutely be part of your toolbox. Though, with that said, if you're trying to block a signal, a toolbox might do a better job at a much lower price, assuming it's made of metal. Like the segue to our sponsor, Corsair. So you want to build a PC, but you don't know the difference between a 12-pin and a bowling pin, or maybe you do, and you just want to reduce clutter with one standardized cable that connects everything. Well, Corsair's IQ Link ecosystem could be the answer. You can create a chain of devices using the same simple connector, all leading to a single IQ Link system hub that can be attached to your PC's frame using the mysterious power of magnets. Not even famed scientist Dr. Shaggy Two Dope knows how those work. Oh boy. Each of the hub's two ports can handle up to 7 connected devices, which reduces cabling complexity, and with a range of products in the ecosystem, like coolers, power supplies, and even fans, building a fully connected PC is a breeze. Because fans, get it? Oh, and you can customize the RGB lighting of all your Corsair devices with their IQ software. Check out Corsair's IQ Link smart ecosystem at the link. Not cued, it's just a regular link down below. If you guys enjoyed this video, maybe go check out the one where we bought router RF blocking enclosures. Yeah, that's right. That is a thing that is actually for sale. It turns out they're just paper holders that have been rebranded and they don't really block that much.